James Dwight Dana. James Dwight Dana, 1813 to 1895, was an American geologist, mineralogist, volcanologist, and zoologist. He made pioneering studies of mountain building, volcanic activity, and the origin and structure of the continents and oceans around the world. The U.S. Navy sent him to the Mediterranean while he worked for them. James Dwight Dana was born in Utica, New York. In 1830, he entered Yale College and after graduating in 1833, accepted a position teaching mathematics to the midshipmen for the U.S. Navy. In 1835, he wrote a paper on Mount Vesuvius. From 1836 to 1837, he was an assistant in the chemical laboratory at Yale, and from 1837 to 1841, he was a mineralogist and geologist for the United States exploring expedition in the Northwest. His 1841 article for the American Journal of Science and Arts described the rocks and minerals and geology of the Shasta region, and his sketch of Mount Shasta was published. From 1850 to 1892, he was the Silliman Professor of Natural History and Geology at Yale College. In 1846, he became editor of the American Journal of Science and Arts, and he was a major contributor of articles on geology. His 1849 publication of the Geology of Mount Shasta was made famous by the publicity surrounding the California Gold Rush, and he received many requests for more information on his findings. In 1880 and 1881, he led the first geological study of volcanoes of Hawaii. He theorized that there were two volcanic chains, which he called the Loa and Kea, and in 1884 he returned to Hawaii. In 1890, he published a manuscript, Hawaiian Islands, detailing his findings that was to be the ultimate source of information on the island's volcanoes for decades. In 1848, he wrote the Manual of Mineralogy, which is now in its 23rd edition and remains the standard college textbook in mineralogy. In 1877, Dana was awarded the Copley Medal by the Royal Society of London, the Wollaston Medal by the Geological Society of London in 1874, and the Clark Medal by the Royal Society of New South Wales in 1882.